If you are wanting to actually make your goals and dreams happen in this lifetime, then you have to stop doing these 10 things that I'm about to share with you. But first, we have to talk about how these things are affecting you on a physical level, as well as your psychology, and finally on the spiritual realm. In this video, we're also going to talk about addictive business models, and finally, we're going to jump into these 10 things that you need to stop if you want to actually achieve your dreams this year. So, welcome to Nature's Best channel, where we talk about health, spirituality, and abundance. So if that is interesting to you, please join the community, hit the like button, and subscribe. What happens to our brain? What happens to us physically if we're always doing these 10 things? Well, first, our brain gets a simulated dopamine reward. We evolved to get a reward chemically in our brain by doing things that felt good, such as laughing with our friends and eating very good meals, as well as sharing stories by the fireplace. All of these things led us to want to bond to one another even closer and to enjoy life more. But what happens when these habits get out of control is that you might want to stop partaking in some of these habits, but you will find yourself failing over and over and over again to stop. And this is because these habits that can turn into addictions change our brain chemistry, and they affect how our neurotransmitters communicate with one another. When we're abusing our reward centers in our brain, we are more likely to feel depressed and anxious in our day-to-day life. Because like I said, if you're constantly getting this surge of reward, this surge of a high through these 10 things I'm going to mention later on in the video, in your day-to-day life, when you're at the campground with your friends, it's not ever going to compete with that high that you're getting artificially. So that is why we're more susceptible to struggling with our mental health, which also can lead us to be mentally distressed and not allow us any clarity or any focus to put towards our goals and our dreams and our true selves, which leads us to how do these habits affect me on a spiritual level? Well, number one, when we're addicted to whatever it is, we lose control over our bodies and our minds, right? We are hooked on this dopaminergic high. And so that actually distances us farther and farther away from our source and makes us way more susceptible to developing a dependence. It also numbs our intuition. Whenever we're high or whenever we're, you know, going through this, we are not able to actually think straight with all of our senses, and we're not able to connect to our higher levels of understanding in the world. Lastly, having a form of addiction leads us to isolate ourselves from our family, from our friends, from our connection to God, to Source. So finally, let's talk about addictive business models. There's a model called the fog behavioral model, which states that there are three main principles to make a product or a service addictive. And number one is motivation, number two is ability, and number three is triggers. So let's break it down. What does that mean? So number one is motivation. Let's use social media, for example. So a big motivator that gets people to join a social media platform is, one, being accepted by others. But what's even a bigger motivator than just being accepted by others is to guarantee that you won't be rejected by others. That's the incentive, that's the motivation. And think about it in your life, if that's true. Number two is ability. So again, using the example of social media, we have these platforms that are very easy to use. So it doesn't take any hard thinking skills to partake in this form of activity. Same goes with the purchase of alcohol or cigarettes. It's very easily accessible just by a purchase, right? There's no hard thinking involved either. Three is, yeah, the triggers. So what triggers the need to keep going back? One is your physical environment, at where you actually live and even your virtual environment. And two, it's the social aspect as well. So if people in your life are smoking and drinking, you're most likely going to be finding yourself doing that. Same goes with the social media. Now, what are these 10 things that I am referring to? And mind you, these 10 things are gonna surprise you. And the list goes from least serious to most serious. So I'm gonna go through all of these and I'm gonna let you actually ponder what you think of these. And look, I'll just say this. I'm not saying any of this in any degree is wrong or is gonna harm you, right? Like, ultimately, being present in our day-to-day life is the most important thing we can do. Being present in our day-to-day life, being connected with Source is the most important thing that we can do. Because from there, that's when our real capital S self comes out and directs our life. Otherwise, we're stuck in this material world where we get a whole buffet of options that can lead us down a road that's completely consumed with just the material world, if you know what I'm saying. I personally abide by metaphysical laws as well as physical laws. And ever since I've done that, my dreams and my goals are actually happening. They're manifesting themselves easier than they ever have before. Why? Because I realized that I was struggling with one of these, or many of these, at some point, right? And I chose the conscious decision to say, you know what, no.
Thank you for being patient. Here are the 10 habits you should reconsider.
Number one is living vicariously. By this, I mean choosing to look at somebody else's life and be satisfied with their results. It's a form of hiding. It's a form of saying, you know what, I want what this person has, or I want to achieve what they have, but I don't believe in myself. I don't believe that I'm capable in it. And you constantly find yourself chasing the next person or the next thing to sort of idolize, but you never actually take the action to do it. That is living vicariously. Number two, comfortability and predictability. When you stop going out into the world and when you start saying no to opportunities that are right in front of you all the time for your own well-being, this is an addictive habit that you have to kick to the curb. You cannot live your life constantly comfortable, constantly knowing what to predict, because your life is going to pass
you by.
Number
three is fear.
Three, fear. Fear is one of those things that can become so addictive, because it'll start with one fear of the world or of others, and then it'll turn into another fear, and then another fear, and then all of a sudden you find yourself crippled because you cannot get out of this train of thought, and you are afraid. You are afraid for no reason. If you look around you right now, I can almost guarantee you, if you're watching this video, you are in a quiet place. Or if you're not in a quiet place, at least you're not in a war. At least you're not, you know, there's nobody shooting at your house. There's no need for you to be panicking. And yes, you might be in a situation where you are triggered by fear. You're paralyzed, but you have to understand. You have to understand that the more you give in to this fear, the more that you believe everything you're consuming and that you really feel like you're in danger, the more your life will become that. And if you want to step out of that, you have to trust life. You have to reconnect with yourself. Number four is gossip and rumors. Gossip and rumors. This one can be very addictive, especially if your friends or if your family or if your entire social network is doing it. But I'm going to tell you right here and right now that it's wrong. It's wrong to gossip and it's wrong to spread rumors about people. Because let me tell you one thing. Great people are not talking about others. They are talking about ideas. And people that are mediocre are always finding something negative or something sassy to say about somebody else, when really, they're almost like living vicariously through them, right? Oh, did you hear so-and-so? Look, and there's a difference between talking about somebody in an informative light versus gossiping. Gossiping is like digging deeper and deeper and judging the other person, or even condemning them, or just, you know, adding to the fire. Anyway, so that needs to stop. Five is attention. What do I mean by attention? So again, same, craving that external validation constantly and getting that dopamine high from, you know, acting silly or just being a fool of yourself is not leading you closer to your goals. It's not leading you closer to yourself, and it's separating you from actually being at peace. And eventually, that attention will leave you feeling empty as well, because there's no real substance to that attention if it's not for a greater cause other than just that dopamine high. Six is toxic relationships and friendships. This one can be highly addictive, because having a toxic relationship or even having a toxic friendship gives us a sense of importance, or it gives us a sense of just drama in our lives. But we know deep down inside that this behavior is toxic, and it is damaging our mind, it is damaging our self-esteem, it is damaging our self-worth. If we keep going back to these people, we have to respect ourselves so much that we know that we're worth so much more and that our time is so valuable that we're not gonna waste it on anything or anyone who demeans us, who disrespects us, who abuses us. We have to set those limits. If you find yourself in this toxic relationship, friendship, or even space, it is your responsibility to get out of it, because I can guarantee you none of your goals will be fulfilled, and also none of your higher aspirations as a human will come true in this case. Seven is productivity or overproductivity and hustle culture. Overproductivity and hustle. This one is also guiding you farther and farther from actually realizing your potential on earth. And it might seem counterintuitive, right? Because a lot of us are striving for abundance and wealth, especially in this generation where it's like more possible than ever, right? But burning yourself to the ground and burning out constantly, dedicating your entire focus and life on making more money or getting more things done, that's not gonna leave any time for yourself. It's definitely not gonna leave any time for your family. It's not gonna leave any time for your friends or any form of higher quality activity. So you need to analyze your life and say, what am I prioritizing? Why do I even want to make all of this happen for myself? There are so many people that climb the ladder to the top, whether it's in their own business or in the corporate world or however they do it socially, just to get to the top and realize, like, you know what, I'm still not happy, I'm still dissatisfied, what's missing in my life? Well, I'll tell you what's missing in your life. It's the lack of presence that you're having in your day-to-day life, because you've let this become an addictive habit.
Eight.
These two can become highly addictive habits. One is going out and hooking up with people and getting that rush of dopamine and that sort of, I'm not going to say that it's fake love, but it's definitely a simulation of love and a simulation of true intimacy when it's really not. And as far as that's giving your energy, your most vital energy, precious energy, both male and female, you're giving away all of your creative energy to somebody else or to a screen online. And you're feeding into lust, which destroys the purity of your being and it perverts your peripheral awareness of people and the world. So it's more destructive than you want to admit it, but deep down, I don't have to tell you that your soul is calling you to do something better and higher. And intimacy, all of that is sacred. All of that is creation. All of that is true communion with another individual and should be preserved and respected. 9, social media and entertainment. This can become a huge escape from our day-to-day life, and it can become extremely addictive. And like I said, it can have a very negative effect on your life if you're constantly consuming something other than your reality. If you're constantly scrolling, if you're constantly binge watching Netflix, or even if you're dedicating hours of your day to ingesting these dramas and these stories, like, look, I'm not saying don't do it with any of these things. All I'm saying is that you have to understand that if it's become an addiction or an addictive habit, you need to take responsibility and understand that this has serious implications on your life, and that entertainment is taking away one of your most valuable things that you have in this life, which is your attention. If you're not giving your attention to yourself, to your family, to your friends, to God, you're giving it to people that are buying it off of you. They're buying it off of you. It's a commodity at this point now. It's not precious moments of your life anymore. It's a trade. So be wise. And finally, 10, which is substances. And what I mean by substances, I'm talking about every form of substance that you actually consume, starting with sugar, going on to caffeine, going on to cannabis, alcohol, even abusing psychedelics, and the list goes on and on. You know, depressants, stimulants, opioids, all of that. It's extremely dangerous, and I think that that's the most dangerous type of addiction. And you already know about those. But all I'll say is that if you're struggling with any of these, specifically with substances, that you seek, that you really, really do your best to seek guidance from inside, from your heart, and from your higher nature. Read spiritual texts. Seriously, start believing again that this cannot be resolved without the help of a higher force. What I just want to say is that our life is valuable. Our time is valuable. More importantly than anything, our attention is valuable. And if we are allowing ourselves to give our attention away to others for free and just let our life pass us by, we are never going to be fully in tune with God. We are never going to be fully in tune with ourselves. We are never going to be in control of our mind, and we're not going to be in control of our body either. So consider all of these things. But I just wanted to give you 10 habits to ponder on and to ask yourself, do I need these in my life? Anyway, that is my video for today. Hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you on the next one. Blessings!